This video is sponsored by Squarespace. The Legend of Zelda series is massively influential, being the sole inspiration behind entire franchises and gaming tropes, even a score of not-so-subtle clones. Due to its status and prominence, the Zelda series is referenced in a huge amount of other games, from subtle nods to the Triforce in Ori and the Blind Forest, to entire quest lines in World of Warcraft. This topic was the focus of one of the older videos on my channel, back in Easter 2018, looking at Zelda Easter eggs in non-Zelda games. But there are a huge amount more to cover. And like last time, I'll make it more difficult by limiting the list to only one Nintendo game, because a huge amount of their first-party titles include little nods and references to one another. This video was a suggestion from Peter, who left the idea in the video suggestions page of my Squarespace site, so shoutouts to him. Squarespace were kind enough to sponsor this video, a service I use myself and can genuinely vouch for as an easy-to-use, powerful website-building tool. Squarespace lets you, with its incredibly simple built-in tools, add pretty complex assets to a website that has pages looking professional in seconds. Like how I've added a video of a Hyrulean sunset to a landing page on my site, blurred it, and set it behind a navigation bar, all in a few seconds with the simple menus included on the platform. If you'd like your own Squarespace site, they're offering 10% off your first purchase if you head over to squarespace.com/Zeltic or use code Zeltic. And there's always the free trial which needs no card details, so you can test the service for free. If you want a website for any reason, Squarespace genuinely is incredibly easy to use, allowing for the addition of elements like contact forms, which is the same function used to store the suggestions you guys leave on the site in my Google Drive, with no coding knowledge needed whatsoever. So if you like the sound of Squarespace, head over to squarespace.com/Zeltic to grab 10% off. So, subscribe if you haven't already for more Zelda content, and without further ado, let's look at some Zelda Easter eggs and references in non-Zelda games. Set during the Peloponnesian War in ancient Greece, Assassin's Creed Odyssey lets the player choose which character they use, and for whom they fight. The game's set in a massive open world with a huge amount of depth, and a tiny corner of the game's map is actually dedicated to a subtle Breath of the Wild reference. Atop a small remote island, the player can find a ring of stones surrounding a strange little structure, two pebbles stacked with sticks on either side, and a leaf stuck to one of the faces. This is pretty clearly meant to be a nod to a Korok, tiny magical creatures with leaf masks instead of faces, often found holding a twig in either hand. The ring of stones surrounding the Korok is a reference to one of the most common forms of Korok puzzle, where Link needs to add a missing stone to a ring, summoning the Forest Dweller. Odyssey's Korok is one of my favourite sorts of Easter egg, a subtle but clear nod to Breath of the Wild. Plants vs. Zombies has always been one of my favourite mobile games, one that I put hours into years ago. The game's success of course led to a time travel focused sequel, and eventually the series expanded into a new genre, the third person shooter, with Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare, released in 2014. The game still looks absolutely gorgeous, and combat takes place on a host of colourful, varied maps. We're focusing on one in particular though, Driftwood Shores, which features docks with various boats in the harbour. One boat in particular, with a bright red hull, has a somewhat familiar name, the King of Red Dandelions, obviously a nod to the King of Red Lions, the Hero of Wind's boat from The Wind Waker. And what makes this little reference is that just behind the King of Red Dandelions, we can see an island in the distance, which is incredibly similar to Outset Island, Link's home from the same game, found in the southwest of the Great Sea. We're looking at the island from the south side, and can even see features like the bridge leading to the Forest of Fairies, and Aral's lookout on the western side. Next up, probably the most widely known Easter egg on this list, and one from a Nintendo game, but one too good to exclude. Super Mario Sunshine is probably the strangest of the 3D Mario games, but his seaside adventure is one of the most charming games in the series, introducing a cast of wacky, iconic characters like the Piantas, Toadsworth, and Bowser Jr. An odd little recurring character is Mario's friendly racing adversary, Il Piantissimo, a man disguised in a Pianta costume, who races you similarly to 64's Koopa the Quick. Well, fittingly for a racing character, if we manage to get a look under Il Piantissimo's mask, his face is actually that of the Running Man from Ocarina of Time, or the Postman from Majora's Mask, characters who sprint across the land. This little reference is incredibly hard to see in-game, but it's one of my favourite Easter eggs in Sunshine, even if it is well known. Undertale is a game which, admittedly, I don't know much about. It takes place in the underground, a strange land deep below the surface of the earth, from which the player must try and escape, meeting a host of bizarre, quirky characters and enemies on the way. The game features a brilliantly obscure reference, fittingly, to a few 2D Zelda titles. The Spider Bake Sale is a small shop found in the ruins and Hotland, but the latter's branch is larger, with a spider donut and a croissant on the table. The player can try to buy both items without success, the donut apparently seeming rubbery and the croissant just unobtainable. However, when the player picks up the croissant, they will initially mistake it for a powerful bracelet, before realizing it's just a croissant. This is actually an obscure Zelda reference to the power bracelets in the original and the Oracle games, which do look a bit like croissants. Tom Clancy's The Division 2 is an open-world shooter, taking place in a post-apocalyptic Washington DC. The game hides a bunch of secrets, including Easter eggs and references to other games, and even features one of my favourite Zelda Easter eggs in any game. In the Two Bridges District, players can find a fallen sign on the ground, reading, "When water fills the lake, shoot for the morning light." This is the same text found on a plaque at Lake Hylia in Ocarina of Time, and is actually a riddle on how Link can obtain the fire arrows. The first part of the riddle refers to beating the water temple, as after the defeat of Morpher the lake refills, though this can be skipped. Either way, as the riddle suggests, Link must shoot an arrow towards the morning sun, causing the arrow to fall from the sky onto a platform. When collected, he has access to the fire arrows, flaming projectiles which can be used offensively as well as for the solving of puzzles. Well, the Division 2's sign isn't just a surface-level nod to Ocarina of Time. The riddle works the same way. If the player shoots at the sun in the morning, their bullets become incendiary, able to set targets aflame, a brilliant little nod to Ocarina of Time's fire arrows. Thanks for watching this video. A huge shout out to not only Squarespace for sponsoring the video, who you should check out with a link in the description, but also Peter for suggesting the video, and Jihab and Telos for grabbing some footage for me. Thank you all so much. Cheers guys, and I'll see you next time.